Welcome. This is the second lesson in the CCT Data Center course. In this lesson, we're going to describe cloud computing.
All right. Coming up with a good definition of cloud computing can be difficult because there's such a wide variety of cloud services and how they're delivered. But the definition that I have here works in most cases, I think, and that would be utilizing an external data center to host applications available across the public internet. And then, of course, if you didn't know, there's been a massive push to move on-premise data center function to cloud data centers. Operating expenditures are just regular expenses that happen on an interval. And so really, these are finance functions, but they're important because it influences how IT has begun to structure itself. All right, on this slide, we're going to be analyzing a lot of the trade-offs that you make when you're making the decision between moving from a traditional on-premise data center to cloud computing. First is the Capex, Opex issue. The reason that organizations are starting to favor the low Capex, higher Opex model is because it's more predictable and it's easier to budget for. When everything's on-premise, you'll often have these unforeseen massive expenses when you have to refresh hardware. The next trade-off has to do with management complexity. Having your own on-premise data center comes with a lot of complexity. It requires staff with a lot of expertise. You have to worry about all the stuff like redundant power. You have to perform your own upgrades, replace your own equipment. You have to worry about troubleshooting your own problems. If something goes massively wrong, it's on you. And with the cloud, or if you want to move to cloud computing, as opposed to that, all of that complexity is completely invisible to the organization. Now, you do lose direct control over the environment variables in the data center. So depending on what applications you're running, that may or may not be desirable. And the last trade-off here is it's difficult to scale with on-premise. So if you wanted to drastically increase your capacity very quickly, cloud computing can do that almost at the snap of a finger because the cloud providers have standby capacity ready to go, you know, if you want to pay for it. All right, so now we're out at Cisco's site. I've Google searched for Cisco What is Cloud Computing, and this is the page that Cisco has up that just gives that general information about what Cisco's interpretation of what cloud computing is. And so this basically has to do with the concept of who's using what hardware. With private cloud, there's going to be some dedicated, you know, data center resources, and only your organization is going to be using it. With public cloud, there's going to be a set of data center hardware, and there's going to be what they call multi-tenancy, which means that multiple organizations are basically going to be on the same physical hardware, but it will be logically divided. And then hybrid cloud is going to be a combination of the two, where your applications and your computing is distributed across both private and public clouds. And then there is one more that's not listed here, which is community clouds. So community clouds is going to be shared between multiple organizations. Examples of this would be universities, hospitals, or, you know, institutions that need to collaborate with each other. So here we have the different types of cloud computing services: infrastructure as a service, platform as a service, and software as a service. So for infrastructure as a service, you're going to want to think servers, storage, networking hardware, so really the components of a data center. For platform as a service, this phrase right here, software tools for application development, stuff like direct access to database servers, stuff like that. Software as a service is an application that your end users consume. It's located in the cloud and they access it.